Ave Maria, Ave, Ave, Ave Maria.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who prepared a fit dwelling place for the Holy Spirit in the heart of the Blessed Virgin Mary, graciously grant that through her intercession, we may be a worthy temple of your glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, I charge you in the presence of God and of Christ Jesus, who will judge the living and the dead, and by his appearing and his kingly power, proclaim the word. Be persistent, whether it is convenient or inconvenient. Convince, reprimand, encourage through all patience and teaching. For the time will come when people will not tolerate sound doctrine, but following their own desires and insatiable curiosity, will accumulate teachers and will stop listening to the truth and will be diverted to myths. But you, be self-possessed in all circumstances. Put up with hardship. Perform the work of an evangelist. Fulfill your ministry. For I am already being poured out like a libation, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have competed well. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. From now on, the crown of righteousness awaits me, which the Lord, the just judge, will award to me on that day, not only to me, but to all who have longed for his appearance. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will sing of your salvation.
I will sing of your salvation.
My mouth shall be filled with your praise, with your glory day by day. Cast me not off in my old age. As my strength fails, forsake me not.
I will sing of your salvation.
But I will always hope and praise you ever more and more. My mouth shall declare your justice. Day by day, your salvation.
I will sing of your salvation.
I will treat of the mighty works of the Lord, O God, I will tell of your singular justice. O God, you have taught me from my youth, and till the present I proclaim your wondrous deeds.
I will sing of your salvation.
So will I give you thanks with music on the lyre for your faithfulness, O my God. I will sing your praises with a harp, O Holy One of Israel.
I will sing of your salvation. All stand, please.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Blessed is the Virgin Mary, who kept the word of God and pondered it in her heart. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Each year, Jesus' parents went to Jerusalem for the feast of Passover. And when he was 12 years old, they went up according to festival custom. After they had completed its days as they were returning, the boy Jesus remained behind in Jerusalem, but his parents did not know it. Thinking that he was in the caravan, they journeyed for a day and looked for him among their relatives and acquaintances. But not finding him, they returned to Jerusalem to look for him. After 3 days, they found him in the temple, sitting in the midst of the teachers, listening to them and asking them questions. And all who heard him were astounded at his understanding and his answers. When his parents saw him, they were astonished. And his mother said to him, "Son, why have you done this to us? Your father and I have been looking for you with great anxiety." And he said to them, "Why were you looking for me? Did you not know that I must be in my father's house?" But they did not understand what he said to them. He went down with them and came to Nazareth and was obedient to them. And his mother kept all these things in her heart. My dear friends, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Our Gospel for today is what we commonly say, the lost and finding of our Lord Jesus in the temple. If you're praying the rosary, it will be the fifth joyful mystery. But the title, Lost and Finding of Jesus in the Temple, is all about the perspective of Mary and Joseph and the perspective of the readers and also our perspective. But for the perspective of Jesus, it is just saying that it is the start of the day that I work for my Father. Yun lang po iyon. Pero when Jesus reasoned out with his parents, with respect, no, hindi siya sumagot ng pabalang-balang, in-explain niya yung side niya. 12 years old na po ako. Kailangan nandun na ako sa bahay ng aking ama. Nagtatrabaho na. Pero para kay Maria at kay Jose, hindi pa. Bata ka pa. Hindi ka pa hinog. Alam din ni Jesus na kailangan niyang makinig kay Maria at Jesus dahil ihinabilin siya ng Ama sa kanila. Joseph and Mary are the ones taking good care of Jesus and they are answerable to God for Him. Kailangan pa nilang alagaan si Jesus. So, nung sinabi sa kanyang, uwi muna, sumama ka muna sa amin, hindi na nagpumilit si Jesus. Sumama siya at nakinig sa kanila, naging obedient, no? At si Maria, maganda yung last words sa gospel, no? His mother kept all these things in her heart. Ano po ba ang puso? No? Kahapon po, sinelebrate natin ang Sacred Heart of Jesus. Ngayon po, Immaculate Heart of Mary. It's all about the heart. Bakit po puso? Dahil ang puso, doon nananahan ang Diyos. Hindi pinilit ng Diyos na manahan sa ating utak dahil pwede natin siyang kalimutan at madalas nakakalimutan natin siya. Pero kung nananahan siya sa ating puso, sa bawat galaw ng puso, sa bawat tibok ng puso, nagpapaalala ang Diyos na naandyan siya at gusto niyang manahan sa ating puso. Hindi man immaculate yung puso natin, may bahid man ng kasalanan, doon pa rin gusto ng Diyos tumira. Dahil importante ang puso. Pagka tayo'y may mahal, ang inaalay natin, hindi naman yung kamay lang natin eh. Hindi naman yung utak lang natin. Hindi lang yung katawan natin. Yung buong pagkatao natin. At ang simbolo ng buong pagkatao natin ay ang puso natin. Dahil kapag huminto sa pagtibok ang puso, hinto na rin ang ating buhay dito sa mundong ito. Doon, gustong manahan ng Diyos. And when Mary kept all these things in her heart, she also pondered, she also remembered the very first day that the Archangel Gabriel told her that you would be the Mother of God. When she said yes, hindi alam ni Mama Mary yung lahat ng mangyayari sa kanya. Pero lakas loob niyang tinanggap yung mission na iyon dahil mahal niya ang Diyos at siya'y naatasan maging nanay ng Diyos, maging nanay ng manunubos, maging nanay ni Jesus. At hindi rin siya pababayaan dahil may katuwang siya, si San Jose. Hindi siya pababayaang mag-isang magpalaki ng anak. In the word heart, no? Spell natin ano? H-E-A-R T. In the word heart, right smack in the middle of the word heart is the letters E-A-R, ear. Makinig. Saan ginagamit ang tenga? Sa pakikinig. Binigyan tayo ng Diyos ng dalawang tenga pero isang bibig. Dahil mas kailangan nating makinig ng marami kaysa sa magsalita. Dahil sa pagsasalita, mas nakakasakit tayo ng tao kaagad. Ang taong nagmamahal ay nakikinig. Kaya nga, kahit hindi natin nakikita ang ating puso, may reminder ang itsura ng puso. No? Pag nakita natin yung ating tenga, ano yung hugis nito? Oh, ganyan. Pag pinagsama natin yung tenga natin, maghuhugis, puso, heart. So may kaugnayan parati ang heart sa listening. Kung tunay tayong nagmamahal, matututo rin tayong makinig sa Diyos. At aanyayahin din natin ang Diyos na manahan sa ating puso. Kaya't sa ating Santa Misa ngayon, sa pagtanggap natin ng komunyon mamaya, ihanda natin ang puso natin. Hindi perpekto ang puso natin, pero humingi tayo ng tulong sa Diyos para sa pagtahan niya dito, maihalin tulad niya sa puso niya at sa puso ni Maria. Amen.
Please stand.
May My dear brothers and sisters, let us pray to God, our loving Father, that following the example of Mary, we may always seek and do His will. For every petition will answer, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Church may practice the humility of Mary in willingness to serve God and men. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Christ may find a welcome abode in the hearts of people as He found a well-prepared dwelling place in Mary. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
The true spirit of prayer may deeply penetrate the hearts of people that may hear the cry of the poor as it's permitted the whole being of Mary's immaculate heart. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are sick in mind and body may find a healing and consolation through the powerful intercession of Mary. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dying may look up to the Mary as their source of strength and comfort as she stood by the cross of her son. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In silence, let us pray for the intentions of this Mass and also for our personal intentions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, our Father and Master, cleanse our hearts that we may receive Christ, your only Son, in the spirit of Mary's faith and obedience. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Please be seated.
Lord, we gather today. In your house, we kneel down and pray. We ask for your mercy as we open our hearts to receive your forgiveness, O Lord. Lord, we lift up to you all these gifts we offer for your glory. We will eat this living bread, we will drink this saving cup, and feel your presence, O Lord. As we offer this bread, and as we bring you this wine, bless them, Lord Jesus, feed us now, give us life, send us your Spirit, the source of our lives, and together we will serve you with love.
Please all stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Look, O Lord, upon the prayers and offerings of your faithful, presented in commemoration of Blessed Mary, the Mother of God, that they may be pleasing to you and may confer on us your help and forgiveness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to praise, bless, and glorify your name on the feast day of the Blessed Ever Virgin Mary. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived your only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal light, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exaltation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim. Holy,
holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who come in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please all kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of our faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us pray like Jesus. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed
be
thy
name. Your kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And do not bring us to the test, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our many sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please all kneel.
This is Jesus Christ, the Son of Mary, the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. How blessed are we invited to his supper.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
To all who will receive the Holy Communion, please say Amen when the priest or lay minister saying Body of Christ and reverently consumes the Body of Christ before leaving at the front of the priest or lay minister. Please be guided accordingly.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you, and blessed are you among women. Maria, Ave Maria, who is simple and fair in loving God, you're the woman Mary is your name. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you, and blessed are you among women. Maria, Ave Maria, Ave to the eve of our redemption, Ave to the name of Mary. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you, and blessed are you amongst women, Maria. Ave Maria,
is simple and fair. In loving God, you're the woman Mary, is your name. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. And blessed are you, blessed are you among women. Maria, Ave Maria.
Mabibili pa rin po ang ating opisyal na imahen ni Jesus Nazareno. Ang mga ito po ay mabibili lamang sa ating Parish Finance Office. Ang malilikong po na pondo ay gagamitin sa pagsasaayos ng ating Adoration Chapel at Baptistry. Sa darating na June 22, 2024, Sabado, magkakaroon po tayo ng binyagang bayan para sa mga batang 0 to 7 years old, handog sa kapistahan ng kapanganakan ni San Juan Bautista. Sa mga nagnanais, maaari kayong pumunta sa records office ng parokya na matatagpuan sa ground floor ng Cardinal Sin Building mula alas 8 ng umaga hanggang alas 5 ng hapon. Para sa mga katanungan at detalye, maaari kayong mag-message o pumunta sa FB page ng parokya. Ang huling pagpapatala o pagpapalista ay sa June 18, 2024, Martes. Pagkatapos ng misa, wiwisikan po ang lahat ng banal na tubig. Pinakikiusapan ng lahat na manatili lamang muna sa inyong mga lugar, tanging sa Quezon Boulevard o Plaza San Juan lamang ang labasan ng lahat. Sumunod po tayo. Maraming salamat po sa inyong pagdalaw at pagsisimba sa Basilica Menor at Pambansang Dambana ni Jesus Nazareno. Tumayo na po ang lahat.
Let us pray. Having been made partakers of eternal redemption, we pray, O Lord, that we who commemorate the mother of your Son may glory in the fullness of your grace and experience its continued increase for our salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Please. Lord be with you.
And also with your spirit. Please kneel. National consecration to the Immaculate Heart of Mary. We have recourse to your protection, O Holy Mother of God, as we recite the words of this antiphon with which the Church of Christ has prayed for centuries. We find ourselves today before you, our Immaculate Mother. We, who make up the body of Christ present in our land, recite the words of this act of consecration and entrustment in which we gather, first of all, the hopes and anxieties of our Filipino people at this moment of our history. Mother of our people, we rejoice in the name Pueblo Amante de Maria, a people who love Mary, bayang sumisinta kay Maria. You know all our sufferings and our hopes. You who have a mother's awareness of all the struggles between good and evil, between light and darkness, which afflict the world today. Mother of our people, accept the cry which we, deeply moved by the Holy Spirit, address directly to your heart. Embrace with the love of the Mother and Handmaid of the Lord, our people and our land, which now we entrust and consecrate to you, For we are truly concerned for the earthly and eternal destiny of every individual among us and for all our people. We have recourse to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Despise not our petitions in our necessities. Dearest Mother, we consecrate and entrust to you our lives, our families, our nation, our archdiocese, to your loving and immaculate heart. From hatred, violence, and conflicts which divide and destroy our people, deliver us. From sins against human life, from its very beginning, deliver us. From the meaning of the dignity of the children of God, deliver us. From every kind of injustice in the life of society, deliver us. From readiness to trample on the commandments of God, deliver us. From the loss of awareness of good and evil, deliver us. From sins against the Holy Spirit, deliver us. Accept, O Immaculate Mother of Christ, this cry, laden with hopes and burdens, the sufferings of each one of us and of all our people. Let there be revealed once more in our history as a people the infinite power of the redemption, the power of merciful love. May it destroy the power of sin and evil among us. May it transform consciences. O Mary, Mother of Jesus and our Mother, our life, our sweetness, and our hope. Amen. Please stand.
Please bow for the blessing. Blessed are you, O God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. You have given us your only Son to be our way to you. Make us follow him generously, faithfully, and lovingly. Merciful Jesus of Nazareth, you have revealed God's grace and unconditional love for us at the cross. You set your church in this world from which the true light would shine for all to see. Grant that we who enter this holy shrine may walk in your ways as disciples of justice, peace, mercy, and hope. We offer our prayers for the sick, the oppressed, the youth, and those in need most of your mercy. Hear our humble petitions. Bless these religious articles that we may be fervent in prayer and charity. As we continue our journey as your pilgrim people here on earth, may we set our hearts on the road to heaven, our true home and reward, where you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life and your heart.
Thanks be to God.
Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.